You're mad at me. I can clearly tell you're mad at me. I didn't do another episode of Superman Thon since July. It's now September. It's fall now. Can you blame me? Do you know what the next movie is? It's Superman 4!
When I was a young kid, I thought that Superman 4 was one of the best Superman movies that was ever put on film. As a matter of fact, when my dad bought me the VHS, I said to myself, that's it, you know, I'm not gonna watch any other movie. This is the only movie I will ever watch. And as time progressed, I went to the internet and looked up Superman 4, and people hated this movie. People said that Superman 4 was one of the worst Superman movies that was ever put on film. And I was thinking to myself, it can't be that bad. But after seeing a Nostalgia Critic's review of Superman 4, I can't believe what was going on in the movie. I was like, this can't be what I was watching.
Got the disc with me right now. Let's just get my suffering. I actually liked it. I actually liked it. It's not the best Superman movie, no, it's one of the worst. It's a really stupid movie. The acting's bad. The music is the effects are terrible. The plot, it makes no sense. But that's why I like it. I like Superman 4 still. I mean, I'm not gonna watch it for the rest of my life like I said when I was little, but I actually like it. I don't need to be scared now. Yes! 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 I just hit the button off. Doesn't matter. Welcome to another episode, finally, of Supermanathon. Today we're going to review Superman 4, The Quest for Peace.
The greatest hope against the threat of nuclear war is Superman.
War prophets.
He's created the ultimate weapon to annihilate the Man of Steel.
Alright, so you can see it is nighttime right now where I am. It is 4:45 right now. I was busy editing my review of Superman 4. I just didn't like the way I was rushing it because I was finally happy. Then I was like rushing, I was excited that I was actually filming something for once. And not just a video of me chasing a bird in my house. Well, not necessarily chasing it, just running around the house screaming. But, yeah, I apologize for that video, by the way. So I'm redoing my review right now because in the previous day, I didn't talk about what was stupid about the movie or why the movie was good and all that. But I just, we're just going to redo it. And by the way, I do have to be quiet because there are people sleeping in my house right now. So if you can't hear me, I'll try to work on the editing thing to make it louder, but there's nothing I can do. There's absolutely nothing I can do. So without further delay, let's get started. First of all, I've heard a funny rumor about this movie that Christopher Reeve actually written the previous script. Like, he wanted it to be a very serious movie after Superman 3. Of course, Superman 3 being a horrible shit stain it was, he wanted to make a serious movie for once. But then this company decided to fuck it all up. They wanted to make a Superman movie where he fights for world peace and all that. And of course, they had to do some really stupid villain plot, having a Lex Luthor grab a piece of Superman's DNA, which is his hair, and a 1,000-pound ball. Like, his hair wrapped around a 1,000-pound ball. I will admit, that was genius. But Lex Luthor grabs a pair of scissors and just chops it up, and there he has the hair. That was the stupidest scene in the movie. That was absolutely stupid. That is the biggest plot hole of everything. Everything. You have Superman's hair. His hair, which not even a regular scissors can cut. I don't think a garden scissors, you know, those big scissors, I don't know what they're called at the moment, but the scissors, you know, you're supposed to chop up bushes with, I don't think that could cut up Superman's hair. Unless he injected that scissors with kryptonite, I don't know, maybe it'll work. It was stupid. And then he makes Nuclear Man. and I will admit Nuclear Man was kind of cool, but they just did him wrong. I mean, the idea is cool. It's just everything about him was wrong. Another pointless scene of Superman flying with Lois Lane, and it's a complete ripoff of the previous one. It's almost like from scene to scene, but the last film was actually beautifully shot, and it was very touching. And I don't get, you know, I can't take a lot of things seriously. I took that seriously. That was a beautiful the soundtrack, everything. This was the exact same, you know, flying sequence, except it was stupid and pointless. Last scene, I only like things if they make sense. This absolutely did not make sense whatsoever. This sucked so badly. And they did the same, you know, make out with Lois Lane so he'll forget and all that. I don't know, maybe he just needed her advice or something, just completely... The whole makeup thing just kind of bothers me. The little kid that writes a Superman to get rid of all this, you know, nuclear disaster, which isn't really explained well to Superman. He's a very pointless character. Yeah, he was important to his story, but, like, they could have made him more. They could have made him more important than just having him in a couple scenes, and then boom, that's it. Then we have Superman 4. Everybody here was pointless. Everybody. Even Lois Lane, she really didn't have a part in this. She was barely in Superman 3. Then you have her in Superman 4, and she's not even the character that's worth giving a shit about. I mean, you would think that she'll try to get that Nuclear Man in the end of the movie. He's going after some woman. And you think he'll be going after Lois Lane? That would make more sense. No, he's going after some blonde chick who just worked in the Daily Planet, and she was hitting on Clark Kent and all that. And then you had this really stupid scene where, you know, everything is here stupid. I can't go on. But the one scene that really pissed me off about this movie, Nuclear Man going to Metropolis, and he's looking around, he's like, where's the woman? As Superman swoops down, he's like, oh, give it up, you'll never find her. Even though I have no idea who the hell you're talking about, you'll never find that. If you don't tell me, I'll hurt people. And Superman's just like, stop it, no, don't, stop. My God, Superman, you're more of a whiner than Edward Cullen. And then you have this really dumb fight sequence where Superman and Nuclear Man are fighting all over the world. Not powers, blocking the sun, breaking the laws of physics. This whole movie's a mess. Now let's talk about some of the things I like about this. The acting. The acting is not that bad. I mean, some of the acting is way over the top, but it's like that enjoyable over the top, like Nuclear Man. Here's actually something funny. Gene Hackman actually voiced Nuclear Man. And Nostalgia Critic was right. I can't even imagine how funny it would be to have Gene Hackman in a studio booth going, "Rawr!" I think that would be hilarious.
Nuclear Man just belched? I mean, what was that? What are you laughing at?
See, I just had this wonderful image in my head of Gene Hackman in a recording studio having to do like 30 takes of that.
Yeah, that's pretty funny.
Margot Kidder did good. Christopher Reeve always does great. Not as good as the three previous films. It seemed like he really didn't want to do this movie. It seemed like he wanted to do the movie that he wrote, which I don't blame him. I bet that movie would be fucking fantastic, but... Can't always get what you want. The effects are shitty, but they're the laughable shittiness. Like, the effects you're just watching, like, oh my God, you gotta be kidding me. This is so funny. They're like that. That's what I like about this movie. There's no way they had to take this film seriously. There's absolutely no freaking way. The soundtrack was meh, you know, regular Superman soundtrack. Sometimes a theme song could get a little bit kind of boring because you're hearing the same thing over and over again. You expect more, and when you do, it sounds ear bleeding. But at some points, the soundtrack is actually pretty cool. So yeah. I really like this movie. I really, really do. I get a ball watching this movie because of how bad it is. It's like The Room. Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, is my guilty pleasure. I love this movie, but I also hate this movie as well. So, let's go to ratings. Okay, here we go with the ratings of Superman 4. It's stupid, but it's a good stupid. I have to say, I definitely enjoyed this film better than I did Superman 3. I have to give Superman 4 The Quest for Peace a 4 out of 10. See what I did there before? I did that joke last review episode. Alright, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Supermanathon. I'm no longer going to be slacking. I'm going to keep doing this. I'm probably not going to do it once a week. If I ever do a marathon, I'm not going to do it once a week. There's just no way I can, because I never live up to it. I mean, I'm gonna try to keep uploading constantly. It's just if you don't see any episodes in a while, it's not my fault. It's my schedule. So there's nothing really I can do about it. So all right, thank you for watching. Tune in next time when we get the review, Superman Returns. Oh boy. So hey everybody. See you next time.